We are in Helotes, Texas at John T. Flores Country Store. And tonight we're playing a sold out show, wide open. It'll feel as normal as it's ever felt. And tonight will be on fire, it'll be absolutely magical. When you walk in Floors, you kind of get this sense of just kind of the icons that have played here. You can kind of feel that presence here. It's old and rustic, and it's incredibly raw, and it's incredibly real when you walk in here. And if you look on the walls and stuff, there's pictures of Willie and pictures of Hank Jr. and pictures of Johnny Cash, and so many people you've looked up to for so long have played here. So just to be a small part of the story here is an honor. I grew up in a town called Conroe, Texas, and when I was 10 or 11, my older brother Tyler was all about Pat Green and Randy Rogers and Crossing the Ragweed and Jason Boland and Chris Knight and James McMurtry and Hayes Carl and Slade Cleaves and Ray Wiley Hubbard and Wade Bone. I mean, it just goes on and on and on. And I kind of fell in love with all those bands too at a really young age, because I remember standing in the crowd at their shows when I was little and being like, that's what I want to do.
Yes, I'll meet you in the middle. Well, ain't nobody told me it'd be this hard. Yes, I'll meet you in the middle.
Meet you in the middle. I wrote that song when I was 21, and I was trying to write for the record, The Limestone Kid. Hadn't been writing anything, nothing good had been coming out, and then just boom, verse, chorus popped out, and that was Meet You in the Middle. And that was our first song that really kind of went boom for us and started everything.
So much left I had to learn. Grandpa's shaking all this cancer, just in case you hadn't heard. Yes, I'll meet you in the middle.
I say all the time, the only reason I've been able to do anything is because I come from the greatest people in the world, seriously. My sister, my brother, my mom, my dad, my stepmom. Oh, I'm lucky to have three of my grandparents left. We just grew up like that, very close-knit. And my granddad was a great cowboy, had two ranches, one in Central Texas and one in East Texas. Every summer I was growing up, I worked at my granddad's ranch. I've mowed, you know, thousands of acres, hot summer days. Big tractor and bat wing mower, slinging seed, working cows. And that's where we were deer hunting and bird hunting the fall. And bow hunting whitetails really what I've fallen in love with the last several years. It was a great thing to have in my childhood, and I've written a lot of songs about it.
Who wouldn't love to see Parker McCollum at John T. Flores Store in Texas?
We've been following him all over Texas. We're here in Helotes tonight. I mean, he's just an excellent artist, wonderful singer.
We couldn't be more proud of how far he's come. We've been listening to him for a long time, and we are just amazed at what he's been able to do.
You know, growing up in Texas, listening to Cross Candy Ragweed and Randy Rogers Band and Pat Green, and you always hear about him playing Flores Country Store. And I grew up, you know, kind of on the other side of the state. And so I'd never come here until I played here. And we played on this stage in here, the small stage, to, I think, 20 people probably the first time we ever played here. And now we sell it out, 4,000 people outside. It is so cool to get to be one of the kids that, you know, comes here and plays for nobody, and then you come here and play for everybody.
What's going on, Floors? Holy s***!
And man, there's so many people in the state of Texas that love country music. And so it was everything for us. I mean, we started in a van with no trailer, and we would play all these super tiny shows and rodeos and county fairs and stuff. And that's really where we cut our teeth and kind of developed as a band and found out who we were. So, which I think we're still working on, and hopefully we'll always kind of be chasing that.
I was a little nervous tonight, man. Y'all sold it out a month in advance. You got me nervous, Floors.
What's rowdy about Texas crowds and Texas shows, and Floors Country Store in particular? They hit record on their video on their phones and throw them on stage. I guess hoping that I'll pick them up. Sometimes I do, and it turns out pretty cool. They throw underwear and beads and cowboy hats and the occasional beer. I think they're just out there having such a good time, getting so rowdy, man. They can't control themselves. And we're nothing without them, and they're the best in the world.